everyone. In our last class, we discussed some concepts like electric charges, basic properties of the electric charges, Coulomb's law, and the dielectric constant. So, in this session, we were discussing the concept like the force between the multiple charges. Okay. So, here the expression for the force between the multiple charges. We already know that the mutual electrical force between the two charges, which is always given by Coulomb's law. Okay, so now we find out the expression for the force between the multiple charges. So how we find out? So here we use the principle of the superposition. Okay, so according to the principle of the superposition, the force of any charge due to the other charges always equal to the vector sum of all the forces due to the other charges taken one at a time. So that means here we consider what? The force of any charge. So that is always equal to the vector sum of all the forces. So here I consider the three charges. So first consider the charge Q1, Q2 and here Q3, and the distance between these two charges is given by R12. Okay, then the distance between these two charges is what? R13. Okay, so here I consider three charges, so that is Q1, Q2 and here Q3. The distance between these two charges, so that is equal to what? So R12, and here the distance between these two charges, so that is given by R13. So here this shows that the force on the charge Q1 due to charge Q2, and here this force, so that is on the charge Q1 due to charge Q3. So here we find out the resultant force for the charge Q1. So here when we draw a line for this, so here this is F12 and here this is F13 and here this is F. So here F indicates the resultant force on the charge Q1. So now find out the resultant force on the charge Q1. So first we write the force on the charge Q1 due to charge Q2. So that is given by the Coulomb's law. Okay, right? The expression for that is the force on the charge Q1 due to Q2. So we write F12, so that is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R12 square into R12 cap. So here this is in the vector form. Okay, next try to watch the force on the charge Q1 due to charge Q3. So next is force on the charge Q1 due to Q3. So here we write the expression for that, F13, so that is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q3 divided by R13 square into R13 cap. Okay, next we find out what? The resultant force on the charge Q1. The resultant force F, which is equal to what? The vector sum of all these forces, right? So here we consider, so F12 plus of 3. So when we consider these charges of 2n, so that is equal to what? 2n. So that is equal to F1n. Okay, next we substitute this relation to this expression. So then we get what? So we write F which is equal to F12 plus F13 up to F1n. Okay, so write F. So that is equal to F12. So we know that. So that is 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R12 square into R12 cap. Okay, next is F13. So that is plus 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q3 divided by R13 square into R13 cap plus up to what? F1n. So plus 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Qn divided by R1 n square into R1 n cap. Okay. So here in this relation, Q1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, take it as a common. So that is Q1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. Okay, write the remaining terms. So that is equal to what? Q2 divided by R12 square into R12 cap plus, so here remaining is Q3 divided by R13 square into R13 cap up to what? F1n. So that is equal to what? Qn divided by R1n square into R1n cap. Okay, so next. So next step, so here this is equal to what? Q1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. So we write it relation as summation I which is equal to what? 2, because here we consider 1. So next consider what? 2 up to n. So here Qi divided by R1i square into R1i cap. So here this indicates the what? The expression for the force between the multiple charges. Okay, next we move on to the concept, so that is electric field. Next is electric field. So electric field is defined as the force experienced by a unit positive charge placed at the point. That means here the electric field always away from the positive charge and towards the negative charge. And here the SI for the electric field is Newton per Coulomb or volt per meter. Okay, so here the electric field always what? Away from the positive charge. Away from positive charge and towards the negative charge. Okay. So next, what is the expression for the electric field due to a point charge? So now we find out the expression for the electric field due to a system of charges. So before going to that, first we find out the expression for the electric field due to a point charge. Okay, so here the electric field due to a point charge. charge. So here I considered two charges. So that is first is capital Q and here small q. And here at point P, so when the distance between these two charges, so that is equal to what? R. And here this direction shows that the electric field always away from the positive charge and towards the negative charge. So that means here we consider this Q as positive charge and here this Q as negative charge. So that means first we find out the force, right? The force exerted by the charge Q on the charge Q. So that is given by F, which is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. So here Q and Q. So capital Q, small q divided by R square into R cap. Okay, then we know the relation for the electric field. So electric field, so that is equal to F vector divided by Q. So then we substitute the F. Okay, so that is 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q Q divided by R square into R cap whole divided by Q. So in this expression, so here Q Q gets cancelled. So the remaining term, so that is 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by R square into R cap. So here this indicates the expression for the electric field due to a point charge. Okay, so that is equal to what? 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by R square into R cap. So here we see source charge and the test charge. Okay, so source charge means, first one is source charge. Okay, next is test charge. Source charge means the charge which produces the electric field. So here the test charge means what? The charges which is used to detect the presence of the electric field. Okay, so next we move on to the next concept. So that is the electric field due to a point charge. Okay, so that means your electric field due to a system of charges. So next is electric field due to a system of charges. So before going to that, so first we write the representation of the electric field for positive charge and for negative charge. So here this is for positive charge. So here this is the positive charge. The electric field always away from the positive charge. And here this is for negative charge. For negative charge, the electric field always towards negative charge. Okay, so here this gives the representation for the electric field for the positive charge and here for negative charge. For positive charge, the electric field readily directed always outward. So here for negative charge, the electric field directed always inward direction. Okay, so these are the representation for the electric field for the positive charge and the negative charge. Okay, next we derive an expression for the electric field due to a system of charges. So next is the system of charges. So here the electric field at any point always equal to the vector sum of all the electric fields due to the individual charges. So that means here I consider the three charges. So that is Q1, Q2 and here this is Q3. from point P to the charge Q1, so that is indicated by R1, and here this is R2, and here this is R3. Okay, so here this shows that the electric field always away from the positive charge. So that means here we consider these charges as a positive charge. Okay, so here this is E2, and here this is E1, and here this is E3. Okay, so here we find out the resultant electric field at point P due to these charges. So that is, first we write what? The electric field at point P due to charge Q1. Okay, next write what? The electric field at point P due to Q2 charge. Okay, next write the electric field at point P due to Q3 charge. Okay, next we see what? The resultant electric field. So that is equal to what? Vector sum of all these electric field. Okay, so first write the electric field. The electric field due to charge Q1, so that is given by E1, which is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. So here we consider what capital Q has? Q1, right? So that is Q1 divided by R1 square into R1 cap. Okay? So here this is in vector form, right? So when we write this vector form, so that is E1, which is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 divided by R1 square into R1 cap. Okay, next write what? The electric field at a point P due to charge Q2. Next, electric field due to charge Q2, which is given by what? E2. Okay, so that is E2, which is equal to what? 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. So here we consider the charge Q2. So Q2 divided by R2 square into R2 cap. Okay, next is the electric field due to a point charge. So that is what? Q3. So that is electric field. Electric field due to a charge Q3. So that is equal to what? E3, which is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q3 divided by R3 square into R3 cap. Okay, next we find out what? The resultant electric field. Write the resultant electric field E, which is equal to what? E1 plus E2 plus E3. So when we consider up to N charge, so that is equal to what? Up to En. Okay, so we write E1 plus E2 plus E3 up to En. So then we substitute the electric field, so that is 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 divided by R1 square into R1 cap. R1 square into R1 cap plus, so then write the what? Electric field due to a charge Q2. So that is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q2 divided by R2 square into R2 cap. Okay, then write what? The electric field due to a charge, so that is Q3. So that is given by 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q3 divided by R3 square into R3 cap. So then write what? Up to what? En. En means what? It's the n charge. So that is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi q1 divided by r1 square into r1 cap plus q2 divided by r2 square into r2 cap. Okay, then q3 divided by r3 square into r3 cap up to what? So here this is qn, right? So qn divided by rn square into rn cap. So next is what? 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. So when we write it as a, so that is ij is equal to what? 1 to n. And here this is qi divided by ri square into ri cap. So here this gives, so this gives the expression for the electric field due to a system of charges. Okay, so here first we considered what? 3 charges, right? So that is q1, q2, q3, and the distance between these two charges is r1, and here these two is r2, and here these two is r3, and this shows the electric field for the what? q2 charge, and here this is for electric field, so that is for the q1 charge, and here this is for q3 charge. So here we find out what the electric field, resultant electric field, right? So that resultant electric field always equal to what? The vector sum of all these electric fields due to the individual charges. So first we write what? The electric field at a point P due to charge q1. Okay, next write the electric field at point P due to charge q2. Okay, next is electric field P due to charge q3. Okay, then we write the resultant electric field, so that is equal to E1 plus E2 plus E3 up to En charge. So when we substitute, so finally we get what? The electric field, so that is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught summation I is equal to 1 to N Qi divided by Ri square into Ri cap. So in this class we discussed some concepts like the electric field due to a point charge, electric field due to a system of charges, and also the force between the multiple charges. The remaining concepts will be discussed in the next class. Thank you.